What's up, guys? Jesse here with another video for you today. Sorry about the audio, which we're not going to be seeing any gameplay anyway, but I actually got my headset hooked up now, and I've got to figure out a way to just unhook it real quick so like you guys can hear game audio. But anyway, that's off the subject. But anyway, today I'm going to give you guys a best class setup for the Ball 27, because you know how everyone goes try hard with this weapon. Everyone uses it pretty much. So anyway, let's get started. So first off, of course, you got your Ball 27. You go into the attachments. You've got to have foregrip. That's a necessary. Personally, I like to run quick draw. Some people like laser sight or stock, so you can move around fast. Even extended mags. That'd be the only thing that I might suggest is extended mags, because sometimes I'll go for like a 15 gun streak and I'll run out of ammo or anything. You might just want to put scavenger on here too, but we'll talk about that later. But so I've got foregrip, quick draw, and you can run it with or without a sight. Right now I've been testing out the red dot sight on it. I usually don't run it with anything. Maybe even take that off and put a silencer on it. It's really all your opinion pretty much, but this is what I'm running right now: foregrip, quick draw, and red dot sight. It's working out pretty good for me. As far as perks go, I sometimes like to put the low profile so you're invisible to UAVs, but it's sometimes I'd rather go for an extra attachment on my gun, so I just leave it out. I've got lightweight. Actually, I need to switch this. I like, let's see, fast hands once you unlock that. And then I got toughness and blast suppressor, because you know those are, you know, your have to perks. This one so you don't flinch when you get shot at. And this blast suppressor, so when you're jumping around using your exo movements, you're not like showing up on the mini map. So let's go right over here to the right some more. I've got my UAV with threat detection, support, and extra time put on it right now. I get that 10 times a game probably, or you know, somewhere around in there, because I get a UAV a lot, and I figured why not make it support, and I'll put threat detection on it and stuff. So I really like that. So I've got my system hack here. I've got assist points on it. So once I get it, usually I can get a couple assists to get me just closer to this warbird here. Sometimes I'll run the paladin. It all depends. Sometimes I like to run the warbird because I can move it around. The paladin kind of moves by itself. And like I said, it's just personal preference, but I go with both of them. So feel free to use any of them or just whatever you guys want, but this is just my suggestions. Exo ability, sometimes I don't even run one. They're not necessary. They're not like a need to. You know, I gotta have this. Only thing I would say is if you're playing like momentum, I would run, let's see, where's the overclock so you can run faster. I like doing that sometimes. See, I can get to that flag first, capture it. Secondary, I don't run any of that because you don't need that. You don't ever use secondary unless you're like, you know, on a sniper. But exo launcher, that's the only thing I give up whenever I use three attachments, is I don't get a Simtex. And that's kind of, I kind of like it, but I kind of don't. It's kind of win-win, lose-lose. I mean, if I use this, I'm good with the red dot sight or silencer. And then, but I don't have a launcher, so if I play domination or something or anything, I like to throw grenades. So I don't have that. But anyway, guys, there it is, that you're using all your 13 points. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll back out here real quick. I'm almost prestige 4, actually. I'm almost prestige 4. So be looking for a prestige video here in the, like, coming soon. But anyway, guys, I'll talk to you guys next time.